With the rise in twin and multiple pregnancies comes more mothers whose pregnancies are considered high risk. KCTV5's Amy Anderson takes a closer look at the life-saving services offered at one of our local hospitals.
I'm definitely tired, but it's great.
Sarah Hammontree got to take one of her twin girls home just the other day. The other baby will stay here at Overland Park Regional for a few more days before joining her sister. Hammontree's pregnancy was high risk from the start. She'd had two previous surgeries on her uterus, and that meant her pregnancy would be extra risky, even with one baby, let alone two.
I mean, there was a moment of joy for sure and excitement, but it was followed very closely by just kind of terror.
That's because the risk for problems jumps dramatically when a woman is carrying identical twins that share the same placenta. Twin-to-twin transfusion syndrome is common in these pregnancies and very dangerous. It's when one baby gets too much blood, the other too little. It's what happened to little Vera and Iris.
Partway through the pregnancy at about 24 weeks, we had early twin-twin transfusion with massive amount of fluid within one twin.
Dr. Brent Finley worked with Dr. Corey Iqbal on a plan for Hammontree and her little girls. Her TTS was in stage one, which was good news.
Once it progresses to stage two, the mortality rate, the chance of the twins not surviving starts to exceed 90%. So fortunately, she stayed at a stage one.
The team decided to try amnioreduction on Hammontree, a short procedure to pull fluid out, relieving the pressure on her uterus. It worked. If it hadn't, the next step would have been surgery.
When it does progress, then the most common treatment is to put a fetoscope in. Goes through a 3.3 millimeter incision into the uterus, and a laser fiber is used to stop the blood flow through the blood vessels that are connecting the two twins together.
Hammontree suffered one more setback, severe pain the day after the amnio. She thought she was in labor, but it turned out a cyst had ruptured. She was once again whisked upstairs for observation for a couple of days. The babies were born on June 8th at 34 weeks. One weighed 4 pounds, the other five. Hammontree says she's grateful all of the procedures she underwent happened under one roof.
I just can't say enough good things about this hospital and what they offer.
Hammontree says the team of doctors and nurses here are like family now, and says she'll always be grateful for the life-saving treatment she received. Lots of curveballs, but in the end, she was the winner.
You hear people say before you become a parent that, you know, there's just no way to explain it, and there really isn't.
In Overland Park, Kansas, Amy Anderson, KCTV5 News.
For the latest from HCA Midwest Health, go to kctv5.com and click on the Health tab.